before we hit the road.
All right, so we just left Farmington Canyon, where we were, where we stayed overnight. Would not stay there again. Great views, wonderful views. That's about all it had going for it. The road did not get less busy at 8 p.m. In fact, it remained busy until about 1 a.m. Kids coming down or going up the mountain blaring their music, like it was really annoying. And it started again as early as 6:15 a.m. Granted, we were up at 6 a.m., but I wouldn't recommend staying there if you want peace and quiet, because there is none to be had. So we just stopped to top off our gas, and now we are heading up to West Yellowstone to go to the Grizzly and Wolf Discovery Center. Oh, and our shirts today, we have matching. His says hubby. Yay, Etsy!
Getting ready to cross over into another state again. Oh, lots of people are excited about Idaho.
Welcome to Idaho.
Grizzly and Wolf Discovery Center, and we just got here, and this guy is walking around. Oh, gonna take a little snooze. So cool. So her name is Spirit.
She was getting into all those things, and obviously those things are not very resistant, but she was able to.
And she was getting into trash.
She was 6 years old, she actually had two cups. One of them, because she actually started hanging out by a roadside, which are not good places for bears, and it does cool stuff.
Saying she's been here for 20 years after her cub got hit by a car because she liked to hang out by the highway. So she's 26. So it is lunchtime.
like a dog.
Great horned owl. And I come over here, and there are three eagles.
You got a fork in it. Big boy, just shy of 1,000 pounds.
Is he shedding?
Leave it to Rusty and I to find the local bookstore and come check it out. Of course, there's a coffee shop attached to it. It's called the Book Peddler. West Yellowstone. So when we were kids, we used to go to this place called Bullwinkle's. And it was, I don't know, like a fun zone. And this is the adult Bullwinkle's. Look at how good that hazy IPA looks. And huckleberry cheesecake. So good. So we were going to Camp Boondock. Right off of the highway, there's like a pullout where they have like semi, you know, it's like for semi trucks, but we were gonna just kind of camp there. But then we saw in the forecast that there were thunderstorms, early evening thunderstorms today, so we decided to get a room. Also, I slept so badly last night at the spot that we were at, it was terrible. And I just really need to sleep because we have a big day tomorrow in Yellowstone. So we decided to come to this, I think it's called the Moose Creek Inn here in West Yellowstone. It's really cute. Cute little faux wood walls, and we got a king room. I mean, they're small, but It's super cute. You know, like, it's got everything we need, so no complaints. Now all I need is a good night's sleep.
Mr. Rusty over here is getting all ready for the camera.
I put my head to the side.
But I'm hoping that I sleep well tonight, because tomorrow we go into the park and have a full day ahead of us, so I need to sleep.
I need to sleep as well. Please keep your snoring down. I appreciate it. Thank you.
This is my life for the rest of my life.